Always think how I can make it have a personality.
6, 7 out of 10 people would be like, V1, it's done, I love it. But then, will you have a client for life though?
Back home smoking legal. Legal. I got more slaps than the Beatles.
You don't put a limiter on your stereo bus to get it loud. That is already too late. You've already committed to the mix. But if you use a limiter, mix into it.
I can feel like 80 rats in my Mary's. Me and Drizzy back to back is getting scary.
Learning the most important thing, obviously, is game structure, but transients. Ask yourself, how do I get it that loud and yet keep that transient to give me that life? And as you can see, it's now at 2 to 1. Well, now it's 30. And before, it was a little bit quicker. Why do you think I changed it? Transients. I needed more. The second thing, which we're going to be going into next, which I think a lot of you are here for, is the solid low end. That's, damn, that shit is fucking subbing. You can have the most bangingest 20 or 30 hertz. If you can't hear it and it's taking up room with voltage, you're losing. So how do I keep that low end energy without wasting a frequency that I can't even hear? And the R bass is the key with that. Drag the track down, isolate the frequency with the filter, squash the shit out of it, and slowly add it back in. And when you do it like that, you don't have the spikes or the peaks with that frequency you're looking for.
That's one of the greatest pieces of information you're gonna get.
She said, oh, you rich, rich.
You rich, rich.
Bitch, I graduated, call me Big Fish.
You gotta look at sound on how your ear perceives it. And I want something back in the mix. Take away the high end. What's the first thing you hear? The low end in the car when you got the trunk. You put the top back into it. The trunk is open.
Still going bad on them anyway. Saw you last night, but did it broad day.